We look at structural oppression, and within that we are looking at the intersectionality. We see that the central issue of the whole of this discussion is that women experience oppression, and there is variation in this oppression, or ye variation hai in different situations. एक तो ये वेरिएशन है, एक सिचुएशन दूसरी सिचुएशन की बात आ रही है, और दूसरी वेरिएशन है इन द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ दैट लेट्स से ऑपरेशन, हाई इंटेंसिटी ऑफ ऑपरेशन, लो इंटेंसिटी ऑफ ऑपरेशन, एक वेरिएशन इन ऑपरेशन है और एक इंटेंसिटी ऑफ ऑपरेशन है. एक ही सिचुएशन में डिफरेंट women might be experiencing different levels of oppression. So that is how we see ke ek let's say condition hai, another condition hai, another condition hai, ya one configuration hai, ek situation hai, dusri situation hai, teesri situation hai, ya structure hai, ek structure hai, dusri structure hai, teesri structure hai, ya ek kisam ka section hai, dusra hai, रेस है, क्लास है, एज है, रिलीजन है. आई मीन दीज कुड बी डिफरेंट कॉन्फिगुरेशंस, लेट्स सी अपीयरेंसेस इन विच वी ट्राई टू लुक इनटू द ऑप्रेशन फेस्ड बाय वुमेन. वी सी द वेरिएशन एज वेल एज लेवल्स इन द ऑप्रेशन. सो द एक्सप्लेनेशन फॉर वेरिएशन ये है कि ऑल वीमेन पोटेंशियली एक्सपीरियंस ऑपरेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ जेंडर. अब ये तो एक है ना कि देर इज वेरिएशन. दूसरी बात आ रही है कि दैट वीमेन आर डिफरेंशियली ऑप्रेस्ड, डिफरेंशियली दैट देयर ऑपरेशन, द लेवल ऑफ देयर ऑपरेशन इज डिफरेंट, दैट डिफरेंस इज फ्रॉम one woman to another, or one group of women compared with another group of women. So we see that there is variation, and that variation is because of the intersections of other arrangements of social inequality. Or wo other arrangement of social inequality kya hai, wo wahi hai jinka main baat ki hai, ki sex hai, race hai, social class hai, ya कोई और बातें हो सकती हैं. इन्हीं को हम कहते हैं दीज कुड बी कंसिडर्ड एज फैक्टर्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन, और अगर टेक्निकल लफ्ज यूज करें मे बी कॉल्ड एज वैक्टर्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन. सो द वैक्टर्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड प्रिविलेज इंक्लूड नॉट ओनली द जेंडर, जेंडर के बेसिस पे तो वेरिएशन है, लेकिन इंटेंसिटी की बात करें तो उसमें बात आती है कि जब ये फैक्टर्स इंटर लेट्स से एक्शन इनका होता है इन डिफरेंट सेक्शन का, तो फिर वेरिएशन में फर्क आता है. तो ये क्या है जिनकी मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, वो है क्लास है. क्लास में है कि सम आर रिच, सम आर पुअर, सम आर मिडिल क्लास. रेस है, वाइट हैं, ब्लैक हैं या कलर्ड हैं. फिर ग्लोबल लोकेशन है, डेवलप्ड एरिया है, अंडर डेवलप्ड एरिया है. सेक्सुअल प्रेफरेंस है कि मेन को प्रेफर किया जाता है, वुमेन को प्रेफर किया जाता है. एज की बात हो सकती है, यंग है, ओल्ड है, मिडिल एज है. ऑल दीज फैक्टर्स माइट इंटरसेक्ट विद ईच अदर एंड दैट माइट क्रिएट द वेरिएशन. वो जैसे मिसाल पहले मैंने दी कि भाई एक औरत है, वो जेंडर के हिसाब से माइट बी लेट्स से ऑप्रेस्ड. अब वो औरत अगर गरीब है और काली है, एंड देन वो और भी को उसमें फैक्टर्स आ सकते हैं. अगर उस इलाके का सारा रिलीजन जो है वो लेट्स से क्रिश्चियन है, और वो औरत जो है किसी और रिलीजन को बिलोंग करती है, तो देन अगेन शी इज डिसएडवांटेज एंड शी गेट्स फर्दर फोर्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन. So the variation of these intersections qualitatively alter the experience of being a woman. So variation of these, ये बात जैसे मैंने की, variation in the social class of that woman, the variation in the race of that woman, variation in the age of that woman. So, ye intersect karenge to uski oppression ki level fark ho jayegi. Ek to pehle hi fark hai compared with men, aur yahan par aa gayi ke she is further disadvantaged and she get further high level of oppression. So, the argument in intersectionality theory is like this. It is intersection itself that produces a particular experience of oppression. So, it is not just an additive strategy. Add nahin ho rahe, intersect kar rahe hain. Aap keh rahe hain ke cross classify ho rahe hain. Addition ki baat nahin ho rahe. Inki matrix ban rahi hai. Jaise aap cross table banate hain, ye us kisam ki baat ban rahi hai. So, it is not an additive strategy of gender. Yani ke plus race, plus class, plus sexuality. Balki ye intersect kar rahe hain. So, some men and women may be privileged just because of such configurations. So, central point of theories jo hai wo ye hai. Understand the arrangement of inequality as hierarchical structures based in unjust power relations. Aur iske basis pe we look at into the injustices in the society, and that becomes the critical focus for analysis. So, we see that there is a link between ideology and power. So, ideals hain, create kiye jaate hain, aur ideals kaun create karta hai, ya ideologies kaun si hain jo ke prevail karti hain in the country, wo wohi ideologies hain which are created by the people who are in power. So, powerful people create the ideologies, and these ideologies are, let's say, practiced in the society. So, the ideals of superiority and inferiority are created by the dominance. So, we use such ideals with respect to the superiority of race or religion. So, these are practiced in the society. These are used to justify the oppressive practices in the society. Wo aise hi hai jaise hum kehte hain ke white race is there to rule the others. So, everybody who is white is the ruler, and everybody who is a non-white is to be ruled, is to be oppressed. Aur is kisam ki ideals are inculcated in the people as part of the socialization process. So, people are socialized with respect to these evaluations, whether one, let's say, item is one, let's say, characteristic is superior and the other is inferior. So, these ideologies create some kind of mythical norms against which people evaluate themselves, and they get the power, and others might be oppressed. So, that is how we see, and we look at the that kind of mythical norms. If we see something in the American society, and that mythical norm is that somebody who is superior, the mythical norm is that is white, that is race, then physical appearance, that is thin, then that is gender, that's male, then young, heterosexual, Christian, financially secure. So, look at kitne jo factors hain jo ke uske andar aa gaye hain ek mythical norm ke. So, usme race aa gayi hai, usme physical appearance aa gayi hai, usme gender aa gaya, usme age aa gayi hai, usme heterosexuality aa gayi hai, usme religion aa gaya hai, aur usme social class bhi aa gayi hai. Aur ye agar cheeze hain to that is the ideal, and that is powerful, and that powerful person has the power to exploit the others. So, anybody not meeting this norm is devalued. Anybody having that norm, that is valued, that is given higher status, that person gets power over there. And on the basis of that, that could be used as a criteria, okay? That on the basis of that criteria, they can determine that this is my group and this is others' group. So on that basis, they can exclude those who don't meet that criteria. They can punish them who don't meet that criteria, and they might marginalize them who don't create the, that who don't meet that criteria. They might be considered as others. They might be considered as a lower level, and anybody who is at lower level might be exploited. That's the theory on the basis of which we see that whole dominance oppression takes place.